All right, we finally got them, diamond camo snipers. I gotta say, these were actually pretty difficult at first, but as I went along, I was able to come up with some classes for you guys to make things easier. Got a little easier at the end. So let's get into it. Let's get into the first challenge. And for the most part, I'm gonna pair up the Dracon, the semi-auto, and the P06, the three burst. I'm gonna pair those guys together for the first part here, and then we'll talk about the Locust and the SVG, the two bolt actions. Okay, so the first challenge is get 100 shots, and you guys surely know this by now. From the previous Call of Duties, getting one shots with the weaker spam snipers, just go play hardcore. That's pretty much the easiest way you're gonna get one shots with these things, okay? That's a no-brainer, but I gotta put it in the video for people who didn't figure it out. Hardcore domination or hardcore kill confirmed. I do like hardcore domination just because you have a better idea of where enemies are coming at, and obviously you can hear the announcer when they're capping the flag. All right, for the Locust and the SVG, the bolt actions, those are pretty much one shots in any game mode, and so you can play pretty much whatever you like. I decided to play ground war just so I can sit in the back and just pluck off easy enemies, okay? This guide is for people who don't usually snipe, okay? If you're a phase member and you want to bum rush the spawn and do some quick snipes, hey, go right ahead. This is for people who don't like sniping. They just want to get this over with. Try out ground war with your bolt actions and just be calm, lay back, overlook domination, the B flag or something, you know, be part of the team, do something. But ground war is really good. There's lots of targets everywhere, and it's usually on the bigger maps where you have an easier time to not get noticed. All right, moving on to our first camo challenge, Ardent. Get 10 long shot medals, and let's talk about the Dracon and the PO6 first, the semi-auto and the three burst. Same thing, we're gonna play hardcore domination, can hang back, overlooking the B flag. This may be a little bit difficult sometimes because certain maps, they just don't have a long range of sight. And on some maps, I had to like really struggle finding an area. You know, I may have been better off just leaving the game, but that's what you gotta do. Just find a spot on the map where you can hang back as far as you can and get those long shots with the Dracon and the PO6. You could attempt to do ground war with them, but it's gonna take multiple shots and you have a higher chance of being spotted. Okay, no special class here. You can accomplish other challenges at the same time, like the burnt camo or bliss or whatever it is you wanna do. All right, so burnt, get 50 kills without any attachments. Let's talk about the Locust and the SVG 100. And same thing, we're just gonna go ahead and play on ground war. So that's sort of a theme here. Dracon and PO6 is hardcore since they're the weaker snipers, and the Locust and the SVG 100, you can play ground war. That's gonna be the theme going on here. And that's what I did for the no attachments challenge and the five attachments challenge. All right, so we got battle. That is where you get two rapid kills. As usual, this just happens randomly, but if people are capping your flag or if you choose to bum rush the enemy spawn, you could use the heat wave ability and you can jump in there, zap people, and the heat wave is basically like a super stun and they're sort of stuck there for about 1.5 seconds, and then you can attempt to get an easy double kill. But that's something that just happens randomly on its own. But the heat wave is actually pretty good if you do choose to rush enemies. All right, now the one that caused a lot of trouble at first, the Chameleon. That is where you get 5 Bloodthirsties with your sniper only. And the Dracon and the PO6 seem to be easier in hardcore free-for-all. And basically what you wanna do is make a class that's set up, make it seem like an assault rifle, a single shot rifle. So we got the Elo sight, which is sort of like a red dot sight for it. Stock is definitely a must when you're playing free for all. Allows you to pre-aim when you're going around corners or when you can hear somebody. We'll get into that in just a second. We've got blind eye because people will call in care packages and you never know when they're gonna get air support. Blind eye over ghost. Yes, there's a lot of UAVs in free for all, but you actually want people to come towards you. And we do have hardwired, so that way you don't trip up those trip mines. The shock charges and the C4, definitely the trip mines. You don't want to die from those. They're very common in free-for-all. And cold-blooded, same thing. People will get kill streaks, people will call in care packs, they may get a robot sentry gun. You don't want to die by that. Cold-blooded just eliminates that right there. And in free-for-all or hardcore free-for-all, what I think is a must is awareness and dead silence combo. Even if you don't have a headset, you can still hear when people are nearby. And that's why we don't have Ghost. We actually want people to come towards us. You can see this hardcore gameplay here with the Drakon. It's amazing. People do not use Ninja dead silence, and you could just hear them stomping away. And as soon as you get a kill, you want to keep the wall to your back and move. Do not sit in the same place. You're asking to get fragged or blown up with a rocket. All right, you're gonna irritate some people if you just sit in a corner. That is the last thing you wanna do. Get your kill and then move somewhere else. Always keeping the wall or the outside of the map to your back. Okay, you don't want people spawning behind you, and you want to patrol a general area, just switching areas every now and then. Try not to be out in the open. Hardcore free-for-all or regular free-for-all, and treating the Drakon or the PO6 as if it's a single shot rifle. Okay, maybe free-for-all won't work for you. It was definitely much more difficult with the Locust and the SVG, the two bolt actions. So here's another alternative that you can use that worked really good for me. So as usual with the Locust and the SVG, we're gonna go ahead and play ground war, just lots of targets everywhere. Easier for you to sort of slip through the cracks. Class setup, thermal is just gonna help with the target acquisition. Stock, okay, we gotta be really careful here, and stock is what's gonna allow you to pre-aim and sort of creep, just creep along until you can get a nice line of sight on somebody. Blind eye for the same reasons in free-for-all. You don't wanna die by air support. There's definitely gonna be air support in ground war. Flak jacket, you will get naded, especially if you're in the same area. You're gonna irritate people. They will shoot rockets at you. They will throw grenades at you. Cold-blooded, just like blind eye, except for the ground streaks. Don't wanna die by them. Don't wanna be spotted. And awareness is just to help keep you aware of the flankers. There's a lot of flankers in ground war. Just, you know, gotta keep your ear out if you hear some feet stomping to allow you to turn around. And tac mask is sort of like flak jacket in the sense that you're gonna irritate people. They're gonna get pretty upset with you, especially if you're in the same area. They're gonna throw random stuns. They're gonna throw all kinds of things at you. And the playstyle is patrolling an area or being a little bit of a camper, and you gotta be kind of somewhat aggressive in getting those 5 kills. It helps a lot if it's an objective mode. And you know, this isn't the class you have to use, but this is what help with me. And again, this is for people who are not comfortable with sniping. Just overlook an objective with that stock. It allows you to creep on down, creep around, and aiming down your sights. And once they start noticing you, you probably will need to change your position. But in ground war, it's so chaotic. I was surprised at how easily I was able to get bloodthirsties this way. If you think you're part of phase or feeling kind of gutsy, in ground war, you can bum rush the enemy spawn. And that's another way to get a lot of kills, at least get a couple rapid kills. Okay, but that's not for everybody. A lot of people don't want to do quick scoping, quick snipes. They just want to get this over with. And so for the most part, bolt action is ground war, being passive, you know, overlooking your objectives. And for the Drakon and the PO6, it's playing free for all. That seemed to be the best for me, although you can also play hardcore domination and apply the same strategies we use for the Locust and the SVG. So that pretty much wraps it up. Leave a comment. What diamond camo should I do next time? By the way, if you appreciate this video, please take 3 seconds to leave a like. It really helps support the channel. If you want to play with me, open lobbies, contests, updates, all that stuff, I post it on my Twitter or Facebook, links down below, and I will see you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Black Ops 3 tips, tricks, info, updates, all sorts of stuff. It's a playlist. Try to keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side there, we have Destiny tips, tricks, info. It's a playlist. Try to keep that one updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below.